welcome to Ely Cathedral and to the third of these organ meditations for Lent. Today we will hear four pieces of music played by Glen, Dempsey, the assistant organist. The first is by Mendelssohn, his Sonata No. 365. Then two Choral preludes by J.S. Bach, based on the same Choral tune as tiefer. And finally, César Franck's Choral No. 1 in E major. Today's music pays its debts in different ways to one Choral tune. And that's the musical setting for that great song of anguish, Psalm 130. Out of the deep have I called unto thee, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Martin Luther's German versifier of this song, Aus tiefer Not schrei zu dir, from deep affliction I cry to you, was set to a couple of different tunes, but this one, and the phrase that you want to listen for goes, has, as you can hear, a somber dipping and rising to it, which matches the movement of the words, a de profundis shape, if that doesn't sound too fanciful. Luther's rendering of this psalm of anguish and trust was used at his own funeral, and his version of the psalm emphasized the grace of God and the helplessness of his human creatures hanging upon God's mercy. Therefore I will hope in God, and not rely on my merit. I shall abandon my heart to him and trust in his goodness. When my troubles, like chains, link one misfortune to another, then my Saviour will rescue me, so that it all suddenly falls from me. How soon the morning of comfort appears, after this night of anguish and worry. So we'll hear the Choral tune first in a setting which pays homage to that great maker of Choral settings, Bach. Felix Mendelssohn's Sonata No. 3, which is through composed without separate movements, uses the Choral tune in the pedal as an underpinning to the more angular passion of the short, repeated phrase it elaborates above it. So in this version, it acts like a steady prayer, speaking underneath the sharper, shorter passions of human experience. Following the Mendelssohn, we hear two treatments of the Choral tune by Bach himself. In the first, BWV 686, the fugal treatment of the Choral tune acts like Luther's linked chain. There is a relentlessness to its magisterial procession through the different voices, so that the sense of waiting through a dark night of misfortune is played out in the experience of listening. Eventually, in the final resolution, the chain of imitation falls into the triumph of assurance, the rescue that Luther speaks of, which is like morning coming after a long time of waiting and trouble. But what can we make of the way that Bach has made the chain itself out of the Choral tune, so that running through the material of our own imprisonment, we hear, all through the night, the song of liberation, the great promise, not just in the joy that comes in the morning, but woven into the sorrow and trouble of the night itself, saying that God is present in the darkest places. The second treatment of the tune, also a linked chain, is just for keyboards, and it's lighter and faster. It's more like a prelude, less like a fugue, with a more visible exploratory range in tone and in mood. Finally, we hear a piece composed by César Franck in the summer of 1890, during the last months of his own life. This is his first choral prelude in E major. Franck's much more romantic and expansive approach to choral melody is nevertheless hugely indebted to his German predecessors, to Bach and to Beethoven, one of whose musical contemporaries taught him music. Franck's prelude finds its way towards an expansive joy that takes us through almost every other emotion first, in an extended exploration of chorale-like note clusters, again through composed, like a long and complex life, which concludes in the morning of comfort, in reconciliatory joy.
Thank you. Let us pray.
Merciful Lord, absolve your people from their offences, that through your bountiful goodness we may all be delivered from the chains of those sins which by our frailty we have committed. Grant this, Heavenly Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our blessed Lord and Saviour, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all.